Something tells me this isn't baby powder. Let's run a narcotics test on it. Methamphetamine powder, aka speed, crank, chalk, arose by any other name. Meth interferes with the brain's neurotransmitters. It affects the brain and spinal cord. They used to use it for diet pills and nasal decongestants, but today it puts their wreck in recreational drug. Those two aren't quite. Well, it looks like the prospective bride and groom had their prelim honeymoon on this desk. We've done all we can with that item. Why don't we see what Doc Robbins has to say about this first?
The fragment I found appears similar in color to the photograph, so the bird's bill might be consistent with the wound. But without the real thing, it's just a guess. At first I thought it might, but the eagle's bill is much larger than whatever caused the actual puncture wound. This is definitely not the murder weapon. I've got nothing new to report on.
I might be able to help you, but just a heads up. It could count against you in your evaluation. I've updated your case file with a hint.
So you think that hawk sculpture might be the murder weapon, huh? I'll get my boys to start searching for it immediately. Check back later. We have a hostile person who claims he wasn't there, but he has the Vic's blood on him. Let's talk.
Blood on my clothes plenty of times. Rachel had rhinoplasty a few years ago. Since then, she's had trouble with nosebleeds. She had one just before we went to the gallery. I noticed it. I changed my shirt before we left. How did you know that?
We found evidence of your semen inside of her.
Oh. Rachel had a predictable habit. Whenever she got really mad, she wanted to work it off. The fact that Ackerman left us alone, it just made things happen faster. It was the one thing that made her temper bearable. The makeup sex.
Mr. Stock, for a guy who suffered a blow like this, frankly, you seem kind of, clinical about your late fiancé.
I'll do my grieving my own way, pal. But I'm sure you'll find out about this anyway. I was on the verge of calling it off. The whole shooting match. Relationship, wedding, whole deal. Great sex is not enough for all this stress. Rachel was turning into an out-of-control, unreasonable nutcase of self-involved vanity. But I still loved her. All right. After our cool down in the back room, we got into another argument. She started all romantic and sweet, then surprised me with these theater tickets to the most expensive show in town, that Canadian chick who sings real high and all. But I told Rach I couldn't blow off my buddies who've been planning this big bachelor party for me. She was so pissed. What do you want to see naked women for when you have me? I said, Rach, it's not a sex thing. It's a guy thing. I got to spend my last night of freedom with them. That set her off again, but I wasn't having any. I just stormed out of there.
Stormed out? Oh, I thought you kept your cool these days.
I did keep my cool. That's how I kept it, by just walking away. What I hate is that it ended like that, that we parted on that nasty note. Sure, sort of. I was on the highway, busting ass, getting to my pals waiting for me downtown, so I can't prove it, but they'll verify when I showed up. No, I don't do that crap. Neither did Rachel. She had a lot of vices, but not that junk. I can't tell you more than I know.
Goodness, I don't know. Perhaps I stepped in it when I found her. I'm sure that must be it. I just don't remember that clearly. It's all a jumble. I can't think of anything pertinent that I have.
Hey, do you need a hint? I might be able to help you, but just a heads up. It could count against you in your... I've updated your case file with a hint.
You're in luck. One of our Hawkeye detectives found your turkey in a dumpster by the gallery. It's got a broken beak and a few other surprises. Give it a close look.
Hey, Warwick. I could use an update on the art gallery homicide.
Sure. First, our new CSI is all over this thing. We've already got time of death and the murder weapon.
Not bad for your first night.
Yeah, well, let's not break our hand patting our back. We got miles to go before we sleep. Plenty of leads, but no firm suspects. Any ideas, Kath?
Sometimes the evidence we collect has more evidence on it. I suggest you give all your evidence another hard look. Murder weapon, especially. May find something key toward completing your trinity.
Okay, rookie. You heard the boss. Let's go back to square one with fresh eyes. So, the perched predator had a feast for his last supper. Let's test the blood to see what type of mammal was on the menu. Well, the blood on the beak is Rachel's, and the beak fits the wound, so we have our murder weapon. But who killed her? Who's to say where this substance came from, since our murder weapon was found in a damn dumpster? Collected, though. You never know. Till you know. You can run that on the chemical analyzer.
You've got some good evidence on Patrick. I can call a judge and get a search warrant to cover anything with paint on it. Is that wide enough of a brush for you?
I usually use red sable, but I probably have a few squirrel brushes, yeah.
The victim's clothing revealed a paintbrush hair.
And you consider that unusual in an art gallery? You have any idea how many artists work in this town? Hundreds. And you'll find thousands of squirrel hair brushes. Good luck to you. Suppose there's no way of avoiding this, and why I should want to protect that son of a bitch Ackerman, I'll never know. Call it misguided loyalty, but Anyway, financial problems is an understatement. He owes me thousands, and over these past 6 months or so, he's come up with some, shall we say, unconventional ways of reimbursing me when cash wasn't handy. Look, I'll cooperate. I know you have a job to do, but understand that I have a job to do myself. Take what you want, and then please leave me to my work to myself. Art doesn't happen. It's a struggle, and I need my solitude. And it may seem callous, but I consider finishing my artwork a higher priority than finding whoever killed Rachel Maddox. Dig into her life, and you'll find as many people not sorry to see her dead as you will scroll hair brushes.
You'll want a different tool for that.
Well, he offered me his second car, a big screen television from his former rec room, any number of nice, but honestly, secondhand items. I took a few of these offers just to help out, but Nathan's still into me for, well, let's just say the notion of him suing me is amusing. I know he often accepts cash payments from clients, for reasons you could probably guess, detectives that you are. If not, ask the IRS. Sometimes he's had enough cash in that safe of his to paper those gallery walls.
What safe are you talking about?
Oh, it's in his back office slash stock room. Keeps documents, sales records, and so on in there, I believe.
Well, with cash in that safe, maybe you broke in to claim it was yours. And Rachel Maddox just happened to be there, after hours. The very person you wanted to avoid.
Ridiculous! That's slander!
So sue me.
That's outrageous. There's nothing here that has anything to do with your stupid investigation. You're violating my sanctuary.
Well, you're violating this warrant. Move. A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. Killer tickets for the hottest show in town, Night of the Murder. Boy, you're lucky when you land these. A good idea to be thorough. A good idea to be thorough.
A friend of mine gave them to me. I took them to be nice. Didn't really have any interest in that commercial stupidity.
So it must be some friend to give you such expensive tickets. And you must be pretty well off to toss something you could resell for a couple $100. So who's the friend?
I don't remember. A guy I talked to at the corner restaurant, I think.
We'll see about that.